I think we played a good game. It wasn't enough. We will try to be better in third game.
Trenerio trumpas komentaras per rungtynes. Treneris sako, manau, žaidėm geras rungtynes, bet bandysim būti geresni dar kitose rungtynes.
Coach, you impressively managed to come back in the last minutes, but everything was decided by the buzzer beater. How did the final possession...
No, it's not about buzzer beater. It's about not call foul.
Klausimas buvo apie rungtynių pabaigą. Treneris sakė, kad pabaigas sprendėsi ne tuo paskutiniu lemiamu momentu, dėl to, kad nebuvo sužaista pražanga.
Don't you think about filling the protest for the game?
No sense. We had situation here against Juventus, 0.9 second call foul against us. We had situation in Utena, 50-50. Šiaulys 2 or 3 point shot was against us. Now also, so what kind of protest we can make?
Klausimas buvo apie, ar komandą ruožės pateikti protestą. Treneris sakė, nėra tikslo, turėjom jau tokių panašių situacijų.
Is it possible to recover psychologically, mental after such a game and still to try to come back to the series?
Yes, we played a good game, yeah. So we played a good game and for sure we are able to repeat it again.
Klausimas buvo, ar įmanoma psichologiškai sugrįžti po tokių rungtynių seriją. Treneris sakė, kad taip, žaidėm geras rungtynes ir galim tą padaryti.
And comparing to the previous game, what was the biggest difference with the biggest improvement today?
We didn't change anything, just we start game better and then in Kaunas and that's it.
Klausimas buvo, kas šiandien buvo didžiausias skirtumas lyginant su pirmomis rungtynės. Treneris sakė, nieko nekitėm, tiesiog pradėjom rungtynės geriau negu kad pradėjom Kaune.
Very tough game. Lietkabelis played a great game. They hit incredible shots. But we go home with a huge win coming from behind. Suffering, without shining, but there is a lot of Lietkabelis in this. They play physical, they made shots, and they didn't let us have a lot of rhythm, but we found the right chemistry in the last quarter. We did the right place when it count, and we won, as I said, a huge game. We are 2-0, now a little bit of regeneration to refresh our bodies and our brains and ready for another battle on Sunday.
Trenerio komentaras, treneris sakė, labai sunkios rungtynės. Treneris sakė, Lietkabelis žaidė puikias rungtynės, pataikė spūdingus metimus, bet mes keliavome namo su labai svarbia pergale. Treneris išskyrė, kad varžovai žaidė fiziškai, sumetė sunkius metimus ir neleido mums pajausti ritmą, bet galiausiai treneris sakė, kad ketvirtam kelinį pavyko pajausti tą gerą chemiją ir dabar serijoje Žalgiris pirmavo 2-0 ir dabar svarbiausia prieš ateinančias rungtynės atsistatyti fiziškai ir psichologiškai.
Coach, congrats. An impressive and chaotic end of the game. How did the last minute look from your perspective?
I would say that we put together all the right things in the last 4 minutes to have a better, let's say an easier ending. Okay. We just receive the triple shot of Lipkevičius in transition was a big mistake, and this can cost us the game. Then we received the N1 of Gagic, another mistake. And then we had the last defense, Rividis turned the corner, and we overhelped and we received a tap-in. I believe that was a game of single plays, big plays, and at the end, I believe that it's very difficult to play against a team that has this confidence. Big shots from Orelik again, Sirvidis, Gagic playing a great game, and Bičkavičius coming back was a great help for them. But again, we are commanding a win on the road by 1 point on an offensive rebound in the last possession. So it's a good win.
Klausimas buvo apie paskutinę minutę, kaip treneriui atrodė. Treneris sakė, kad pasakyčiau, kad galėjom laimėti lengviau. Treneris išskyrė kelis momentus pabaigoje, kai Žalgiris praleido svarbu Lipkevičiaus tritaškį, tada suklydo. Taip treneris sakė, kai Gagičius pelnė 2 taškus su pražango, vėliau komanda praleido Sirvidį. Treneris taip pat paminėjo, kad sunku žaisti prieš tokią komandą, kuri turi tokį didelį pasitikėjimą, bet svarbiausiai, kad galėjo pavyko pasiekti pergalę.
Coach Keenan played like a true leader. We know everything about him, but forgive me for being repetitive, but we have to talk about Lekavičius again. 4 out of 4 frees and that aggressiveness in crucial moments. If Inkonas gives us the joker, is today an epithet for this game?
I'm very lucky to have Luki. That's the only thing I can say. We are very lucky to have him.
Klausimas buvo apie Luką Lekavičių. Treneris atsakė trumpai, kad tiesiog yra labai laimingas jį turėdamas ir komanda yra labai dėl to laiminga.
After the last game, you emphasized bad defense against Aurelikas. Today he started with 2 frees.
Today was better defense, but he was hot.
What is the biggest challenge defending such a player?
It's always like this. He's a playoff series, you know, players that are on fire, keeps on fire. So I believe that we force him to have tough shots. And the thing that he's making tough shots, even with 2 players on him. We will try to be even better on this.
Klausimas buvo apie gynybą prieš Gedimino Aureliką. Treneris sakė, kad tikiu, kad šiandien pavyko jam labiau apsunginti tuos metimus, bet jis tiesiog atkrintamosios yra labai karštas ir tiesiog sumeta tuos sudėtingus metimus.
Inkonas, you also mentioned Deividas Sirvydis' impressive season in the Euro Cup. Today he was a standout player in the first half. Are we talking about another Lithuanian potential EuroLeague player?
Yes, and but looking at the game, also Aurelik is a EuroLeague player tonight, because if he extends his shooting range like this, and he's so very tough, but you know, I believe that Sirvydis is a true candidate for being a very good guard for Lithuanian national team and playing at the highest level.
Klausimas buvo apie Deividą Sirvydį ir jo potencialą. Treneris paminėjo, kad taip, Deividas galėtų būti Eurolygos žaidėjas. Taip pat jokavo, kad ir Aurelikas galėtų būti Eurolygos žaidėjas, žiūrint taip, kaip jis žaidė ir šiandien. Treneris taip pat paminėjo, kad tikiu, kad Sirvydis yra tikras kandidatas būti labai gera korta tiek Lietuvos rinktinėje, tiek ir žaisti aukštame lygyje.
Do you have more information what happened to Brady Manick?
He twisted his ankle. It's very fresh right. I don't know really. Now it's very. It just happened.
Klausimas buvo apie Brady Manick, ir aišku, kas jam nutiko. Treneris sakė, kad Manickas susižeidė čiurną.
And the last question from the different opera. At the beginning of March, you stated that Olympiakos is your favorite to win the EuroLeague. Has that prediction changed?
Nope.
You go with Olympiakos
this weekend. The truth is that, like Shara said yesterday, everything can happen. So I believe that all 4 teams, never like this year, all 4 teams are real candidate to win it all. Because if Panathinaikos wins, nobody would be surprised. Real is Real. Olympiakos is the third assault to the. And we say the third, in Italy, usually we have an old saying that the third is the right one, okay? And Fener coming in this shape, wow, really can have. Everything can happen, and but if you ask me, I had to pick one, and it could be everything, but my name is Olympiakos just because it's their third attempt.
Klausimas buvo apie artėjantį Eurolygos finalo ketvirtą. Treneris sakė, kad jos pirmas nepasikeitė ir treneris rinktųsi Olympiakos, bet pacitavo Šarūną Jasikevičių ir jo žodžius, kad visko gali nutikti. Ir treneris sakė, kad šiemet finalo ketvirtą visos 4 komandos rimtos pretendentės laimėti ir niekas nenusteptų, jeigu laimėtų bet kurį iš jų.